Hi everyone, it's a cold morning in the Hachimantai region of Iwate Prefecture in the northern Tohoku region of Honshu Island, the main island of Japan, but up far north. I'm up at a fairly moderate elevation here. I'm going to walk down the road with you slowly. I don't want to fall because it's a little bit slick here. Actually, just walk with me for a minute. The reason I'm here is I'm just out peeking around with the idea of checking out this historic for Japan energy resource. Right there behind me in the valley is the Matsukawa Geothermal Power Plant. It's the first geothermal plant constructed in Japan. It was built in 1966. It relies on live steam coming from the ground to power a turbine and generates around 23 megawatts of power. So that's a fairly powerful single turbine generator. The cooling tower is used to cool off the steam and condense it into hot water after it's been used in the turbine. The really interesting thing about this, besides just that it's a sustainable source of energy because it just uses a natural geothermal source from the earth, the really interesting thing to me about this site is that the hot water that's a waste product of this power plant is then piped down the valley, and farmers use it to heat their greenhouses in winter, which is really just, it boggled my mind to learn that fact. So that's really cool. Anyway, one of the issues that comes up with geothermal power, it makes sense that Japan has a ton of geothermal hotspots. There's a lot of volcanism on the island. It's littered with volcanoes. There's lots of hotspots where there's warm water coming to the surface, hot springs galore. The resource trade-off that Japan is facing in this case, though, is whether to build more plants like this or even at a much larger scale, massive geothermal power plants, to replace a lot of the nuclear energy that they're now quite wary of. Japan has mothballed its nuclear generation program since 2011, since the Tohoku earthquake, tsunami, and the resultant Fukushima Daiichi nuclear disaster. So in the context of thinking about alternative energy, geothermal comes up as an obvious solution. However, the resource conflict comes in this way, which is that these geothermal hotspots are already well identified by Japanese who are lovers of going to onsen resorts like these. People like to go and sit in the hot springs, bathe in the hot water, and enjoy nature while they're there. So the resource conflict would be if a bunch of these power plants go into the valleys where there's right now just a bunch of really idyllic, peaceful hot spring resorts, then this would represent an impact to that value, the use value of the hot water for people to just sit and enjoy and recreate. Of course, there's also the risk that if a really big geothermal installation goes in, it might disrupt some of the geothermal activity to the point where the hot springs sources that people are relying on for their onsens might actually be disrupted, and there's some risk that the flow of hot water might be disrupted in a way that the hot springs that are traditional, in some cases hundreds of years old onsen might be disturbed as well. So, in short, we have a really cool, in this case, super old geothermal power plant, 1966, that's been steadily providing power to the region. It presents a historic use of energy source, but also a great potential for Japan. Other places in the world also are tapping into geothermal power as a, not just as a means of generating electricity, but also as a means of heating buildings, in this case, heating greenhouses for farmers. And it does present some trade-offs as well. that with respect to the use of the resources and the potential downsides of any development, including a sustainable one like this. Okay, I'm down at the entrance to the power plant now, and you can see there's this Tohoku Sustainable and Renewable Energy Company brand that manages the power plant, owns and operates the power plant. A big do not enter sign, and I don't know what the rest of it says. I can tell it's not the red lettering, and the big do not enter bar is clear to me, so I'm not gonna try and walk up there and make friends. People will be like, wait, what are you doing here? I'm sure I didn't arrange for a visit or anything, so I'm gonna wait here at the gate. Note that they're just using waste hot water from the geothermal source to keep the bridge from freezing. They're just running hot water on the bridge, and that keeps it thawed out. And then behind me, this massive pipe is just a big conduit taking hot water down the valley. You can see it's just steaming, and the snow is hitting it, and the steam is coming off from it, evaporating all that snow. It's so hot. It's taking that water down the valley. It might be used by some of the onsen along the way. I don't know. The onsen usually have their own source at the spring, which is why the onsen are located where they are. They're located based on where there's already a natural hot spring source coming from the side of the valley usually, and they'll tap it there. But this massive pipe full of hot water steaming away, heading down the valley to be used in heating, including in greenhouses. Pretty cool. You can see typical February weather is snowing around me. It's actually a little warmer than it is usually this time of year. And I have fresh strawberries that were grown in this greenhouse. How cool is that?